Okay, microphone settings.
Microphone on.
Good. Right, set to like the two circles, like the little graph thing.
Yeah, this is where it was.
It should be your far right one.
Yeah.
Check. Levels look good. Just
try not to move, breathe, or speak.
Yeah, just try not to do anything. And put my phone on do not disturb. Done.
Cheers.
Cheers, lad.
Episode 4.
Episode 4. We're getting close to Halloween. Yo, what is going to happen this year?
Nothing.
It's not. You don't think it's going to get shut down?
I mean,
they're going to say, don't go out?
You're not allowed to socialize with your family, according to the 10 people guidelines inside. Like,
what?
You're only allowed 10 people inside your house.
Right. Oh, so like,
so
yeah.
I can't imagine you're going to be allowed to send children to strangers' doors.
Yeah.
And then they take their hand, place it in a box of candy, and throw it into your kid's
bag.
I don't think COVID spreads that way. Everyone's definitely going to be wearing masks anyways on Halloween.
Yeah. I don't know. You could get some asshole that's coughing all into their candy and you just don't know, right?
Yeah. There's always like a razor blade in an apple every year.
Fuck.
This year it'll be like COVID in an apple.
Injected.
I don't know. But we brought
for the Civic Edition.
Yeah.
COVID injected.
I got the red, very red pumpkin for this very occasion.
You mean orange?
It's super red. It depends on the lighting.
It's orange.
It's fucking red.
It looks orange.
It says red as red gets.
Okay. For you guys out there, it's very orange.
This is a very festive podcast, apparently. Not anticipated. But yeah, I think it'll happen. I don't think a lot of people are going to send their kids.
I don't know how they're going to say, like, shut it down. You can't shut it down. Shut it down.
Shut it down.
You know, like, you can't fully stop it.
Well, I don't know what happened in the news today. I flicked on 680 on the way home just to check the traffic. And the mayor of Toronto was talking with all the health officials and shit.
Yeah.
And to me, I didn't pay attention because I don't like just listening to the fucking news.
Yeah, because
it's very negative. I'm not sure if you noticed.
I fucking hate the news.
The name of the game is called Fear, and if you aren't scared yet, why not?
Yeah.
So
be scared.
Basically, from the 38 to 40 seconds, I heard the mayor is saying, "Don't congregate for Thanksgiving," because Thanksgiving's next weekend or this weekend.
Dude, I keep forgetting it's next weekend.
Yeah, this
or
weekend.
This coming.
Yeah,
weekend,
this coming weekend.
Happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
Happy Thanksgiving to whoever's listening to this. It didn't sound like they want people to congregate. They say use your own discretion. They've limited the indoor gatherings to 10 and the outside to 25, but they did that a couple weeks ago. So in theory, like on my mom's side and my dad's side, we're 18 or 20 people.
Yeah, that's crazy.
That's just immediate family. So you cannot, if you want to follow the letter of the law,
you can't see your family.
Can't see your family.
No, maybe
which
your
I think
mom
is
and
fucking,
dad, that's what
I think it's crazy that you tell people not to see their family on holidays, but that's a different, totally different discussion that I'm not sure I want to get into right now.
Yeah.
But that said, Halloween's literally at the end of the month.
I don't think
they're saying we're going to peak in the middle of the month. I don't know.
50-50. I think it's going to peak just in just for October. I don't think we're down. Like, I don't think October is going to be the peak of everything.
No, that's not what I'm saying. Maybe it is what I'm saying.
Like COVID.
Peaked in April. April for us, and that was what they projected.
Yeah,
and they're predicting that the second wave is.
This is like it's
October.
Already been here and it's already here.
Yeah.
So I don't see it. I don't see October being like the highest. I feel like it'll get higher in the later.
I actually
months.
Have this weird thought that it is going to go down as it gets cold.
You do?
Yeah.
You think like right now, just like
right now,
the
because
changing and
people
shit?
Can still be outside, people still feel. Okay,
true.
To socialize, which again,
true.
I'm
golf thing.
Golf, well, no one's getting fucking COVID from golf.
Apple picking still a fucking goddamn thing.
Well, we went pumpkin picking yesterday.
We went apple picking on Saturday.
How'd it go?
It's fucking packed.
Which or yeah,
yeah,
but
we
you're
went,
outside. I'm
we
fine
to,
with that,
dude. It was insane. There was people. Okay, there's rows of trees you can go stand in.
Yeah.
When you get out of your car, go get a bag and fuck off. Don't stand in between two cars where another car can perfectly park. There's multiple times I was like, I was waiting for one.
You have to drive through the aisles?
No, you like, they you have like a little through, road. Right? Yeah, but they have a road that goes like pretty much right through the orchard, like the border of the orchard.
Is this the one that Tony used to work at? The one off of Kiel and that way?
Kiel and 16th.
Yeah.
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 We went there.
Okay.
So like we're driving like up and 15 we're like
15 minutes from your parents' place.
Yeah, yeah. Not even.
All right.
And I'm like, I'm going to park there. They're like, yeah. And then the kid calls over his kid. I'm like, I'll run over your little fucking shit of a kid, dude. I don't give a fuck. And then Audrey's like, just go find another one. I'm like, huh, fine, whatever.
Just be reasonable. Enjoy the festive spirit. And then again,
there was another fucking couple sitting right beside their, like, a car. I don't even think it was their car. They're just standing there. It's like, I'm going to park there. And then the guy, like, looks at me and goes, yeah. And then it took him, like, 10 minutes to move. I'm like, guy, you just, don't, you, four steps and you're out of my fucking way. Let's fucking pick it up here.
This segment is brought to you by CJ's anger.
Oh my God. I just hate people sometimes.
People can be very annoying, but listen, people are a little frazzled. They're outside for the first time in a while. But Halloween, I think they're going to say the same thing they're saying now is use your own discretion. Don't be stupid. Be responsible.
And you know people are going to be stupid.
People are always stupid, though. I don't like
moving when you're in a parking spot.
Yeah, exactly. But I don't like that we limit ourselves to the stupid people in society. I think we should. I think because majority of people aren't stupid. Like, there's some really most of us, like, we're dumb.
Yeah.
99% of us are dumb fucking people.
Yeah.
But there's like the stupid people that like ruin it for everyone.
Yeah.
And I don't want that to happen anymore. So
like 1%.
Yeah, and I think that's wrong. I think the more that we are like, oh, well,
we should just shoot them.
People, no, absolutely not. No, my point is I don't want to limit ourselves to other people's stupidity. Like 1% ruin it for the other 99%.
It's like that with everything, though.
Yeah, but it's a silly way to look at things.
Yeah, trust me, I know.
Yeah, I don't
look at fucking the drone laws. As soon as drones came out, you could do whatever the fuck you wanted with them.
You could crash them into buildings with TNT on them.
Yeah, you literally could. Then you could fly them by airports. There was no laws. They just came out and they were a thing. And like when they came out, it wasn't like they only go 12 feet. No, they go fucking a kilometer high and a kilometer long. Like, and it's a little thing that's like, at the time they were like probably a foot by a foot. Little square thing flying through the air. White.
That can get sucked into a jet engine real easy though.
Yeah, but it's not even that. And when it's 300 meters away from you,
it's far.
You don't see it.
Yeah, it's gone.
You don't see it. You know? So it's like, man, the people that were like spying on people, like, okay, let's be honest. Majority of the times, if you see a drone in the air, it barely sees you unless it's like fucking right in front of you.
A drone is always spying on you. There's no way it's not.
The government's drones.
Yeah, but they're really
high. But not your fucking neighbor that's just flying around.
Okay, have you met my neighbors?
Actually, I haven't.
There's a few people in my neighborhood that are for sure just flying around, peering into people's windows.
No, but
and
like,
I'm
honestly,
that neighbor.
Like, honestly, like, I've heard people, they're like, there was a drone outside my building. It was watching me. It's like, no, lady. It was probably somebody in your office that just got a drone and it is on his lunch break. And is just flying around his drone on his lunch break.
Yeah.
Or it's like people like me, they're either taking pictures of the building. Yeah.
Yep.
And then you get idiots. There'll be a fucking accident on the highway and they'll fly their drone right over top of it and spy on it. Or they'll fly it right beside the airport.
And so this is what I'm saying about idiots is that we don't need to make up draconian laws to limit things just based on the idiot.
Yeah.
So for anyone who doesn't know, you were telling me about this. You could probably explain this better. But you were saying that the drone laws, you have to have a license in Toronto.
Now you do, yeah.
You need a license to fly it.
Yeah.
And do you need a permit to use it?
So as of now, like the laws have changed ever since drones came out. It was like they were changing every 6 months. And it was hard to figure out, like, where the laws were going, what was going to happen. There was always a new course you had to take. But now it seems like they got it locked in. Like, literally.
But dumb locked in.
Not necessarily. You shouldn't
need a license to fly a fucking drone.
Well, again, that 1% that are doing dumbass fucking things.
I'm saying we're done with that. We're not limiting ourselves.
No, but that's what happened, though, is that 1%.
I think you should have some sort of restrictions. Like, within X amount of feet and height of an airport, no drones.
Okay,
but so I don't think that now needs to lead to a licensing of a drone or a permit to fly a drone.
So there is those laws in, I forget what the actual, like, I can't remember it off the top of my head. But literally all of Toronto is a no-fly zone for drones because it's surrounded. No drone zone. Because it's literally surrounded by air force. Like, you have helicopters, like, you got the hospital helicopters, you got news station helicopters taking off from, like, rooftops and shit.
Yeah, and right now commercial traffic's at an all-time low. So I know, working out by the airport, those fuckers come in every 90 seconds, yeah, like, man, clockwork. It's insane the amount of...
Yeah.
It doesn't even make sense where they're... Like, how are they all fitting on this fucking airport?
You've got the, like, Buttonville, which is in, like, what would you call it?
That's Richmond Hill.
Richmond Hill?
Richmond Hill Markham.
Yeah. It's like Red Border.
That's enough... That's where all the
so you got that one, and then you've got the Island Airport, and then you got fucking the big one.
Okay.
And there's also smaller airports all around. Dude, there's, like... fucking 12 airports within like 10 kilometers of my cottage up north. Yeah, and they're all small little fucking...
on farm fields and shit like that.
Yeah. Like, there's a guy that flies his helicopter off of his fucking property, I'm pretty sure, every fucking weekend.
That guy's smart.
Yeah. He literally flies into Toronto for the week. And then on Fridays, we'll see him fly in.
Yeah, he's not fucking with...
Sundays or Monday, if it's a long weekend, he'll fly back. Ain't
nobody got time for that helicopter. What color is his helicopter?
Black.
He flies by my house all the time. Yeah. Every Friday and Sunday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's fucking crazy.
It looks like it's like
it's
an orange.
Smart.
Oh, it's my neighbor cutting shit.
Yeah.
I'm like, he's just cutting up a body. It's fine. Yeah, I see that fucker fly by all the time. But why wouldn't you?
If you can afford it.
Do it.
Yeah.
Anyway, back to laws. Well, you present a very compelling point, but I want to find a way to work it so that works in my favor.
Yeah. No.
All right. So you know the law. So what's a happy medium then? Like, because... for me, just the outside observer looking in,
mm-hmm.
to have a license to fly a drone, especially when you're using it for business, mm-hmm. I think is very silly.
Mm-hmm.
So where is your happy medium as someone who wants to use it for business or even recreational? Like, where's the...
So recreational, they've got two tests you can do. So for business and like commercial work. Like
a fucking driver's test for drones.
Pretty much. So there's a written online test, and then you have to do an in-flight review, which... you should take a weekend course and it will teach you everything you need to do. And then again, like, it teaches, like, you have to have air traffic control on so you can hear if, like, something's happening or flying over. For me, I think...
drones have air traffic control on them?
Well, it's an aircraft. No, you have to have it on your, like, phone. Like, there's apps and shit you can get.
Oh, to monitor the
area that you're in.
I'm like, holy fuck, they're getting better and better every second.
It's fucking insane what you have to do now.
Okay, but I'm saying, doesn't that feel like a bit much?
Yeah, so I think there should be, I don't know, it's tough. With drones, it's a sticky situation, because again, like, you've got idiots that'll push the limits, or go over the limits, and be like, oh no, I was in it, or whoops, uh-oh, and now what? You know, so I think to do commercially and all that is fine. I think if you want to do recreational, I still think they're a little strict on things. Like, let's be honest, when have you, other than being at an airport, what's the lowest you've ever seen a helicopter or airplane? It's not going to hit a fucking skyscraper. So if you're in Toronto and you're not flying like above the tallest building you're by, technically you should be fine. If you're in a residential area, fine. Like, it's the fucking tallest house. I don't know. Fucking 30 feet.
Yes, let's say 30 feet.
So like, you can fly your drone 60 feet.
Sure.
Right?
If a plane comes within 60 feet of your house, it's fucking crashing.
Or even 100 feet, you know? Like,
yeah.
I think 100 feet is pretty reasonable. But again, it's not just drone pilots. It's also like pilots. Like, you got idiots that may fly. I don't know if there's restriction on how low they can fly.
For sure there is.
So you get an idiot in a helicopter flying at 100 feet or dangling around like 105 feet. And then with his fucking little thing.
That's really
hits the drone. You know, like, there's idiots on both sides. So to have it super strict,
here's the thing where that law, let's say there's a 100-foot cap on drones. I guarantee you the 100-foot cap on a helicopter is not 100 feet. So if the helicopter crashes into that drone,
it should be their fault.
It's their fault.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's the thing. Like, I don't know. I think there could be a lot more things. Like, I know back a couple years ago, it was like you couldn't fly within like 60 meters or 90 meters of a person, place, or like,
or thing. Or what thing, is that, an adjective? Much.
Like, you couldn't fly within...
Which one is it?
Now? You couldn't fly within like 60 meters of people, animals. Okay, so sorry, the fucking bird flew within 60 meters of my drone.
Like, oh, wild animal came near you?
How do you stop that? And then buildings, 60 meters of buildings. It's like, okay, literally, you cannot... How are you going to take your drone off the ground? Explain that to me. No matter where you... So I got to take it off in the middle of a field that's 60 by 60. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, I'm in breaking the laws or something.
Which, good luck if you can find that depending on where you're living.
No matter where
some
you are.
Some places it's easy. Some places it's hard.
The best thing I think they did was to create a six... I think it's 6 feet by 6 feet radius around you or like your takeoff and landing zone.
It's called a private square and you're not allowed to touch me there.
Yeah. So like they fucking... That's part of the whole regulation thing. Now, I don't have the work to... like justify doing like a weekend course and paying for the course and the fucking...
It just feels like a cash grab at that point.
It is, but it also is stopping people from fucking flying. Now, the stupid thing is Henry's, VizTech, Best Buy, all those places, you can still
buy one tomorrow.
You can still go buy drones. And the thing is, like, you can buy the little ones. Those are fine. It's like the big ones that have like cameras on them that weigh over like a kilogram or I don't know what I can't remember what the weight is, but there's a certain weight.
A couple pounds or whatever.
Yeah, it's like a pound and a half or 2 pounds or something like that is like the limit.
Which is probably 1 kilogram, 2.2, I guess.
Yeah, something like that. And again, so you could go out and buy like a real small rinky dinky one and fucking zip around your backyard and stuff and be fine because you're under the weight limit. But it's when you hit that weight limit, which majority of the drones that everybody wants.
Because if you have a camera, that instantly throws you over the weight limit.
Yeah. Yeah. It's fucking silly. But again, like I don't have the request nor the like drone work to come in to justify it.
Fair enough.
I love flying them though. They're so much fun.
I like watching people fly them.
Fucking easy. I've crashed mine a couple times. Yeah. Like not like crashed into somebody or a building, like zipping around the field up at the cottage when I first got it. And not paying attention to like how low it was to the ground. Like I was trying to be cool, like fly super close to the ground. Next thing I knew, clipped it with the like little legs. And this thing is fucking
tumbling.
tumbling through the field.
But I got my old man, this is probably 7-8 years ago now. I got him a toy helicopter, which was like, it's pretty good though. Like it was right around the time the drones started coming out.
They're fun, but they're helicopters
hard to fly.
Yeah.
Really
especially
hard to fly.
The little ones. Like you try to take those.
This one was a fair
outside.
Size. I would say this one was probably like 2 feet long.
I had one that was like
don't
maybe
fly
like
in a basement.
8 inches and like this thing like out I could control. Only fly in the house and even then like the wind coming out of the vent was like pushing it,
throwing it way off.
Yeah, we're going I took down. It outside and I'm we're like, going down. come back, and I've got this thing like tilted right. It should have been coming back to me, but it was so windy.
Oh my
Next
God.
Thing I knew, it's in the snow. Like a good thing I only spent $30 on this thing.
How do you like that, by the way?
It's actually really nice.
It is nice.
Yeah, what is it? Buffalo Trace.
Kentucky. So yeah, Kentucky. Yeah. So this bourbon.
Yeah.
I have a buddy of mine that's like, we should just play cards, smoke cigars, and drink bourbon all day. I'm like, you're talking everything I want to hear right now. I'm like, let's do this. So anyways, the weekend carried on. We were up at the cottage a couple weeks ago. And I'm like, forgot about it. It's like 7 o'clock. I mean, you want to try this bourbon? I'm like, it's really good. This guy's like all weekend. He's like, let's drink the bourbon. Let's drink the fucking bourbon.
Yeah, let's do it.
So I crack it open, pour my glass. He hates the bourbon. Doesn't like it at all. Even a little bit. Even
oh
a little bit doesn't he like
God.
It. So I've come to a conclusion on that. Just bourbon in general. Is that we were such
Does
fucking...
Does he like whiskey?
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe.
Because like bourbon is whiskey. It's just a different strain. But like, different. Does he like Irish whiskey? Like Jameson's, Gibson?
Well... Antonia really likes scotch and she hates bourbon.
I am not a fan of scotch.
Exactly. So it doesn't really
it's
matter.
Like
and those are all whiskeys.
Yeah,
I think we've been through this. But so anyway, he fucking pussed out hard on the bourbon. So I had the thought. I'm like, why doesn't everyone just love bourbon?
Yeah.
Because we were such fucking psychopaths about it. with Wild Turkey, which is not the greatest bourbon.
No, but it's pretty, it's not bad.
Yeah, it's not bad now because we forced ourselves to like it. Think about it.
I think I always liked it.
Did you?
Yeah, I never hated it. I don't know if
I always did. Now, I never hated it.
If I'm going to drink
it. But I wasn't ever going to be like, hey, I'll take a bourbon.
Oh.
But now I will.
I do that. I like Bullet. Bless you. I like
Bullet. Also, I'm talking years ago.
No, I know, I know, I know. Like when we started drinking Wild Turkey, I think right after I grabbed a bottle of Bullet.
Mm-hmm.
Bullet's really nice.
Bullet's good.
I like Bullet. I'll drink that on the rocks at a bar all day.
Our buddy Rob, he was the fucking connoisseur of bourbon when we were growing up.
Yeah.
And he had a bunch of shit. There was one, I think it was triple. Yeah, he was into that, but then he switched over to bourbon for a bit. And I didn't like his scotch, but the bourbon I liked better than scotch at the time, and I hated both.
Yeah.
But he had this one, I think it was like triple rose or some shit. It was really, and it was like, I did a shot of it. I'm like, whoa,
yeah,
it's really good. And then did about seven more and
disaster
of a night. But
oh man. Yeah, no, I've never been a fan of scotch. I don't know what it is about scotch, but like we played golf with those two guys. They fucking hooked us up with some scotch.
And that was really good scotch.
Yeah, that was like a fucking $100 Mickey.
But scotch is like anything. If it's good, it's good. If it's bad, it's bad.
Yeah,
like, there's really bad bourbon. There's
but even
really
then,
good
like I did the one shot, and the one shot was smooth as fuck. The second one was too. But as we got on to like the third and fourth, I'm like, probably wouldn't drink this anymore. Like I was going to.
Yeah.
I wasn't gonna say no. It was free.
Faux free.
But at the same time, like I probably wouldn't buy it.
For people that are wondering what we're talking about, we were playing golf a couple weeks ago, and we got shacked up with these two old guys, and I'm sure they were thinking the same thing as we were, like, oh, these two fucking young idiots,
yeah.
And we were thinking these two old farts, and it turned out right from the first hole, we were cracking jokes on the tee, and they were awesome, and luckily enough, one of us, by me, got a birdie on the first hole, which definitely helped because all of a sudden, these two old guys are like, oh, flasky time, it's a flasky, you guys want a flasky? I said, fuck, I'll drink anything at this point. So,
at first, though, like I was like a flask.
I was confused.
I just thought it was a different name they had for a birdie.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay, cool, guys. Like, all right.
Still a birdie.
Right on, flaskies. Yeah.
Let's go flasky.
Don't know what you mean.
So before we tee off on the second hole, these guys pop open this old, like, what was it? Pretty much, like, it was like a derelict bottle. It had, like, duct tape on it.
Yeah,
it was
definitely not the bottle.
Who the fuck knows what this was? So they pop open. They're like, all right, every time someone gets a birdie, we got to do a shot. We're like, oh, fuck yeah. Let's do this. We were up there for the weekend anyway. We were having fun.
Yeah.
So we swigged. I'm like, what are we drinking? They're like, scotch. And right away, my thought was, I'm sure yours was similar, was like, oh, fuck.
Why is it always scotch?
I got to fucking gag this back in front of these two nice old men.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we fucking... We banged it at the bottom, and it's as smooth gets.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what are we drinking? And the guy's like, Johnny Walker Blue. I'm like, oh, that's why.
That's why it's
good. That's why it's very smooth.
Yeah.
Because it's fucking $250 a bottle. Man. That's why. The guy brings Johnny Walker Blue on a golf course north of Barrie.
Yeah, but he seemed pretty well off.
They were well off.
Yeah.
I just was very surprised because if you're just going to be swigging it.
Yeah, who cares?
He wanted it to be nice. I don't blame him now, man.
Yeah.
I thought it was really, but it was a lot of fun. And then the next hole, you get a birdie.
Yeah.
So out of the first nine holes, we had four birdies.
Four birdies. And
four
then
birdies. And back nine, we were fucking all struggling.
Just scrambling for pars.
We were all screaming for birdies, though.
Yeah, we wanted them.
Feeling pretty good after the first nine, I'm not going to lie.
No, neither was I. And then we went out we didn't go out. We just had a beer at the clubhouse there.
Yeah, they were awesome guys.
The food actually wasn't bad. Will we have like the dip or something?
Yeah, spin dip, bro.
Yeah, it was good.
But yeah, I don't know. Have you seen the show Ratched on Netflix?
Okay. I've seen it advertised.
Advertised. So yeah. I saw it advertised a couple weeks.
Because of the name.
Yeah, Ratched Ass Bitches. So I'm going to keep drinking.
Yeah, go for it. So I get my run in today, so that's what I got to do when I get back.
That's okay. This is an exciting conversation. So the show Ratched, I thought was a American Horror Story spinoff.
Oh, I thought it was about Ratchet Girls.
No, it's like, have you not seen, are we talking about different shows here?
I don't know. I just thought Ratchet, I'm like, I'm not going to look at
it. It's not about Ratchet. So it's a drama and it's like from the creators of American Horror Story, which we had just started watching. We're like, oh, fuck. So I thought just looking at it, I'm like, this is a spinoff of, and like in the intro was like one of the most famous characters ever, one of the best villains, her pre-story. It's a prequel to a character from another show or movie.
Right.
And I just assumed that it was from an American Horror Story. So we started fucking hammering out these American Horror Story seasons. it's just not popping up. And I'm like, I should probably Google this. So I Google it quick.
Easier.
Yeah, I Google it quick. And it's based on Nurse Ratched from the movie One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. Have you heard of that movie?
No.
Okay. It's a movie with Jack Nicholson.
Okay.
It's from 1975.
Actually, I think I know. I know the cover.
I'm sure you do. Yeah. 1975. It's 45 years old.
Yeah.
And the synopsis, I have it here. I wanted to read this specifically to you to see what you think this movie's about.
Okay.
Well, it's pretty obvious what the movie's about, but there's a villain in this movie, allegedly, and it's Nurse Ratched.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. Okay. I say allegedly based on what I'm
loosely
about to tell you. So McMurphy has a criminal past and has once again gotten himself into trouble and is sentenced by the court. To escape labor duties in prison, McMurphy pleads insanity and he is sent to a ward for the mentally unstable. Once here, McMurphy both endures and stands witness to the abuse and degradation of the oppressive Nurse Ratched, one we were just talking about, who gains superiority and power through the flaws of the other inmates. McMurphy and other inmates band together to make rebellious stance against the atrocious Nurse Ratched. So that's what this show on Netflix is about. It's the prequel to this girl. So I'm like, holy fuck. I'm like, we don't need to watch all these seasons of American Horror Story. We can just go back and watch the movie. And apparently it's an old classic. I think he might have gotten an award for it. Doesn't matter.
Cool.
So we flick back to watch this. And I don't know if maybe it's a sign of the times. Maybe you had to read the book. But Nurse Ratched is just doing her fucking job. She's not. Man, it's fucking crazy. I don't know. Really, maybe I'm old. Maybe I'm fucking not the way I used to be.
We're not getting any younger.
No, but it's funny how you watch certain things. You're like, maybe if I watched this 10 years ago, I'd be like, fuck Nurse Ratched.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to hit you with the cold. This is not spoiler alert. This movie's 45 years
fucking old. I'm probably not going to watch it.
No, it's fine. This guy McMurphy is not crazy. He pretends to be crazy to get into this fucking insane asylum.
Okay.
All the inmates are crazy.
So it's like Ace Ventura.
It's actually the whole plot. It's the whole plot of Ace Ventura. Down to the dolphin and everything.
Does he come out of a rhino's ass?
Yes. Oh, that was the second one. That was in Africa.
Yeah, that was a good one. So, they were all good. What am I saying?
Yeah, they were really good. So he fakes to get into thing. They don't explain any of this beforehand. He just rolls into the mental asylum.
You know
asylum.
Why they did that? So they could do a prequel of how he gets there.
No, that's not why they did it. Because it was 1975. That's why they did. They didn't want to make fucking films back then. So every shot in this movie is just on the face. It's a close-up of the face. There's a scene in this movie where he's sitting there talking to the warden of this mental institution, Jack Nicholson. And they're sitting there having a chat. And I assume it's only two of them in the meeting. And then all of a sudden it pans. And there's three, like somebody else starts speaking. But it doesn't pan out so you can see who's in the room. It just goes to another person's face. They did that three other times. There's five people in this room. For the first 2 minutes of the conversation, you're sure there's only two.
Yeah.
No, there's five people in this room. Like, how
you
got to
have witnesses. Come on,
how
Chris.
About we just write in one line or maybe just like wide shot so that we know how many people. And then we can commence the meeting.
Establishing shots, so you know.
Establishing premise, whatever the fuck. I'm not a filmmaker, but I think you should maybe go along
maybe
those
you
lines.
Should be.
So Jack Nicholson's a sane guy in a crazy place.
Yeah.
He shows up and he's like, fuck this place. And Nurse Ratched is honestly, right off the hop, she's just literally doing her job.
Just being a nurse.
She's administering pills. There's like, and when I say like half the inmates, there's 30 people on his unit.
Yeah.
And half of them are like almost incapacitated. So they're running a pretty regular, relaxed, like we're going to play music and everything's going to be chill. Fucking Jack Nicholson shows up and decides to literally wreak havoc the entire time. And we're supposed to feel bad for him and think that this bitch who's just literally doing her job and doesn't act. She doesn't kill anybody. She doesn't act manipulative. Dude, she acts like a fucking normal person. Fucking person in 1963 doing their job, which this movie takes place in.
Yeah.
Doing their job while this guy literally steals a school bus, steals a boat, breaks out of prison twice.
Okay, so this is a him problem.
Yeah, this is definitely a fucking him problem. But I go back to the synopsis. The inmates band together against the atrocious nurse. This girl's fucking doing her job. Literally doing her job. The reason I'm so fucking wound up about this is because I just saw this. So,
oh my God.
And so I'm like, we're like, fuck. So we go into watching this movie based on the trailers for Netflix. Like, this bitch is going to be bad, stone cold, evil motherfucker.
Yeah.
100%. And also
she's
fucking super normal. She's totally fine. The fucking guy who's not even supposed to be crazy is acting like a little...
She'll bring you an extra pudding.
He brings prostitutes into the unit for the night. They get drunk. They fuck all the inmates.
Shit up.
They fuck shit up. They get a guy fight. Yeah. Dude, They go fucking crazy.
Sounds like a party.
You know what her response all this is? Nothing. Totally normal. Yeah. Like, follow. Let's follow protocol.
Yeah.
Let's do this, whatever. And
let's not escalate this.
And I guess maybe when you're 16 and you watch this, you're like, fuck this bitch. I just want to do what I want. And if you watch it now, you're
They're just trying to party, bro.
I'm like, I don't know what else this girl's supposed to do. She appears to be following protocol. So we watch this movie to a huge disappointment to Nurse Ratched. And yeah, it's just... So we started watching this Netflix show, and I guess what they're doing is they're just using the name Nurse Ratched and that only, because this bitch is already out of her entire fucking mind.
Yeah.
But she's not nothing like the Nurse Ratched from the movie that she's supposedly leading up to. This takes place 20 years, supposedly, before she bumps into Jack Nicholson. So
Jesus.
I think Christ. It's one of these things where they're like, Nurse Ratched, and then they make everything else up around it.
Yeah.
So... I just thought it was really fucking outrageous.
I liked your version of it where you're like, she is the nicest person.
She is, man. She's not nice. She's cold. She's stern. Sure. But she works in a mental institution.
And she's a nurse.
I'm sure she's a little bit
fed
burned
up with
out.
Everybody's
and based on the movie, she works long hours.
Especially if
she's there from 7 to at least 7 at night.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
12 hours.
At least 12 hours.
Yeah.
Dealing
and
with
when
a
you're
lot
stealing
of fucked
buses
up shit.
And bringing in
He
hopes.
Teaches them how to gamble. He teaches he brings in a deck of cards.
I'd be pissed too and cold.
He brings in a deck of cards that got fucking naked pictures on them.
Jeez.
Also, it's hilarious what you were allowed to use in 1963 in a mental institution. Like, they all had pens and pencils.
Why?
They all had their belts on. They were wearing street clothes. Like, he jumps the fence and all of a sudden he looks like a regular fucking dude. The fence is only 15 feet tall.
Are you sure you didn't fall asleep in the movie?
No, so he comes in with his street clothes. He has the option to wear his gurney, or he can just wear the clothes he came in with. And that's what half the guys do. So literally, he comes in, he's got a bean, he's got a fucking toque on, he's got a jean jacket and jeans on. He looks like a fucking regular ass dude.
He just looks like a dude. So when he's out,
he's fucking,
no,
he's like, I'm just going to go on this boat.
Deuces.
And fucking see you guys later.
Yeah, I'm out.
Steals a fucking school bus, breaks out. It's outrageous. And she handles it way better than
I think I would have.
Yeah, she did a great job dealing with the situation. But based on that synopsis I read you,
you're like, oh, here we go.
Buckle up.
Yeah.
This bitch.
Yeah, she's going nuts.
Yeah.
Who's dying?
She's on one.
What was that lady's name? Dolores from British Columbia? And Dorothy?
Oh, no. The town was called Dolores, but the girl's name was like Coda or some bullshit.
The names
were reversed. Doesn't matter.
Fuck.
Yeah, from the ghost town.
Yeah, that shit's funny.
So.
To go off like the... Netflix thing. I was thinking earlier today, like, I just finished watching the series Kingdom, and it was on, like, I don't know, like AMC or something like that. It was
before
on
they bought the rights.
Before it came to Netflix or whatever. And I watched it when it was on cable and stuff. But it's like, I was thinking, I'm like, it got canceled just before season 3 aired. So there was no season 4. So spoiler alert, there's only 3 seasons. Okay.
So
but
if I'm sitting here waiting for season 4, I've got a long time to wait.
Yeah. Right. Actually, funny thing. I'll continue, though. I'm like, nowadays, like, it's not a very old show. Like, maybe a few years, so Netflix wasn't as big. But, like, going forward, I'm like, if you're only showing your show on cable, and there's no... Like, okay, I understand, like, airing the season all on cable first, then putting it on Netflix or whatever. Now, mind you, I have no idea how all that shit works.
Really? I thought you were a movie producer.
No, not yet.
No,
it's
coming.
But it's like, man, like, dude, do you watch cable anymore?
Mm-mm.
The only time I watch cable.
Sports only.
Yeah, I was going to say, hockey and golf only when I want to take a nap. They can have my nap view. But, like, literally, it's only hockey. And if I'm watching it on cable, I'm only watching the Leafs. I'm not going to tune in to fucking...
Yeah, you're not watching any other
anybody
games.
Else. A lot of the times it's on blackout anyways because it's not aired in the...
I'm not a hockey
in
fan.
Our area.
I'm not... I don't watch... I didn't watch a second
See,
of hockey.
See, because of fantasy,
shit,
I watch a lot of other hockey. Like, I'll tune in and check on, like, Tampa Bay or fucking whoever else I've got people playing
I
for.
I can't do it.
But, like, I watched a lot of Calgary games 2 years ago. But it's like, man, like, at least today, like, one, you can't... compare numbers and cancel a series because you're getting no numbers on fucking cable.
No one watches cable.
That's what I mean. Yeah. So it's like, fine, air it there, but don't cancel it because it's not doing good on cable. Put it on like Amazon Prime or Netflix or what's the other? Crave.
Yeah.
And see how it does there. If it does poorly there as well, okay, yeah. Cancel that bitch.
Yeah, throw that shit
in. But like, garbage. What are you, like, how are you guys comparing your numbers? Are you comparing it to like how good Friends did back in the day or how good Big Bang Theory did? Like, or Grey's Anatomy? Like,
I'm sure it's
I'm
sure it's an ever evolving target.
But it,
I'm sure they just average it out. Like, they know that cable is dwindling down. So if they can get, say, 1 million per episode, I'm sure that's doing really well now.
Yeah. I just,
especially like, in Canada, well, 1 million per episode in Canada is like a Leaf game. That's no, there's no way a cable TV show is getting that in
that's
Canada.
What I mean. It's like, but like,
maybe in the States, a million's a decent number. I think
before, because I've watched so many series and it's like they either leave the season on a cliffhanger or it's like, okay, come on, there's still more of the story that needs to be told. And they just, it got canceled.
You bail it out. You know who used to be the worst for that, which weirdly wasn't cable, was HBO used to do that quite a bit.
Really?
They would run like 2-3 seasons of shows
and then
they would bounce them. And HBO was a subscription basis. So whether you're...
They owned boxing rights.
Forever.
Forever. So they weren't hurting for money.
No. So, but they had two shows that I distinctly remember growing up watching that were good shows. Well, I mean, it's subjective, but they were 2-3 seasons. They had a thing going, they end the all both seasons on a cliff note, and then fucking boom, they cancel them, it's done. But back to that fucking Ratched thing, I think the reason
is it Ratched,
but I'm just gonna pronounce it Ratched.
Yeah, I thought you were saying Ratched.
Well, that's how they
ratchet
say it.
Ratchet asshole.
That's how they say it, but I can't do the
they don't date. Know how to pronounce
if
these.
I had to look up how to pronounce this because I reading it, I couldn't. It's like Ratched. I didn't know what the fuck I was doing. I'm basically illiterate. So anyway, I feel like when I watched One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, also it's an old movie.
Yeah. So I have a tough time getting through the ones.
It was
nowadays.
Here is the thing. So this movie was dated, but the reason we kept watching because the acting was really fucking good.
Yeah.
Where I can watch a movie now that's totally up to date, but if the acting's bad, I'm flipping it off.
So yeah.
I'm not watching it.
If the visual effects are really good,
this movie didn't really call for it.
I'll stick around, but like it's like I have a tough time. Like me and my brother used to watch the original three Star Wars all day, every day.
I can still watch those.
I have a tough time getting through them.
You do now,
Yeah, because the fight scenes are so goddamn awful. It's like, man, really? Like,
all right,
couldn't have made that look a little.
The
more,
new trilogy has the best graphics you can offer, and they're terrible films.
But again, it's got great visual effects. Yeah, go watch it.
I guess
it's like Avatar. Like Avatar, like the effects in that were fucking phenomenal.
So watching this movie, but also it takes place in 63. So it's purposely dated to that effect. But I was thinking, am I like, because I've seen a few movies before in the past where I watched them when I was younger, then watched them again when I was older and found my like, I thought that like the main character was like the good guy and shit like that. And I watch it now, I'm older. I'm like, this guy's a fucking prick.
Yeah.
Like, now I know why everyone's mad at him. He's a fucking dickhead. Yeah. Whereas, like, I was on his side younger. So I feel like maybe that is sort of the vibe you were supposed to get with Nurch. Ratcheted it. Is there any movies that you've watched recently that you flipped around on? Like, you saw them when you were younger and then went back to rewatch them. And it's like, oh, this guy's a fucking dickhead. Or, you know what I mean? Like, you see it completely different? Or have you not done that recently? I've done quite a bit of that. I say that, but I can't list a bunch of movies.
Yeah.
But there's ones that I distinctly remember talking with my fiance about it and like, nope, like this movie's totally changed for both of us completely.
See, I don't think I've watched that many older movies lately to really give you an opinion.
I just mean ones that are even 10 years older. Like shit that you would watch when you were in high school and flip it back now and you're like, I thought this was a good movie. It's like, no, this guy's just a shithead.
Oh, man.
I wish I could fucking bang off a couple of, but you know what I'm saying? Try it.
No, I will. I definitely will. One movie that does come to mind is like the original Fast and Furious. And I will watch that.
Garbage movie.
I will watch that every day of the week till I die.
I hate that franchise.
I love them. Now, don't get me wrong. As it continues, it is getting a little ridiculous and like...
A little.
But I'm still going to go watch it. I'm still going to get the DVD.
And that's fine.
But...
Oh, you're like, buying the DVD and everything.
Yeah, I got to finish my set, bro.
Oh, fuck.
But
were we talking a couple episodes ago about how you don't need to stock DVDs anymore?
Yeah, but like the cases look cool, bro.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Come on.
All right, go on.
It's nice having a hard copy every once in a while. Right. Does come with a digital download. Relax.
You got to settle the fuck down.
But like the original one, like they were all like, other than Paul Walker, I think everybody else was like kind of new to acting, or a lot of them, or haven't done a lot of movies per se.
You know, for 13 movies later, it's like they're all still new to acting.
But like, well, okay, like the sister's actually a good actor.
I don't know. I haven't
Jordana
seen past,
Brewster.
I haven't seen past the
anyways,
third one. Yeah,
anyways, the acting is not...
It's garbage.
Not good at
but
the
you're watching
one.
It for what it is. It's a cheesy action flick and that's fine. You're allowed to like those. Yeah.
Fucking,
totally, I'm just busting your balls over it.
No, I know. But like, what also gets me is the style of cars back then. Because
aren't they all Civics? I'm sure they're all like just souped
Honda
up.
Honda Civics.
With NOS in the...
fucking Mazda RX-7, although that is a fucking phenomenal car. But it's the graphics they stick on the side of them.
Oh, the decals.
Like, oh my God, it was so ridiculous. And I remember, like, I remember
how many flames were on cars?
Too many.
All the cars had flames on them?
Yeah. Any kind you wanted, you just had to pick which car had the right ones for you. It was absurd. And I remember back in the day, like...
Best movie ever.
Playing, like... Did you ever play, like, Midnight Club on PlayStation? It's a car game. But again, you could put those fucking... Or, like, Need for Speed. You could put those stupid fucking graphics on.
They look
on.
Great.
Dude, and it was like, bro, check my car out. Look how cool it is.
Look at the fucking flames coming up. I put silver flames on them. It's a black car.
Yeah. Dude, it's so ridiculous, but it's so funny. Just
so that movie doesn't hold water for you anymore. It's just too dated.
It's dated, but I'm still going to watch it.
Okay.
Like, so the first one is still, like, my favorite, but, like, yeah.
It doesn't make you think, like, these guys
It's
are,
just an
yeah.
easy, for me, it's an easy to watch sure, yeah. fucking flick. And it also, like, brings me back. Like, again, that was a movie me and my brother watched all the time when we were younger. Like, mm-hmm. at my grandparents, when we'd go to their place in the summers. Like, same with the original three Star Wars. That's what we watched in the two-day drive to get to my grandparents' place.
Yeah, the one that holds up for me to this day is Mrs. Doubtfire. I watch that with my cousins. Family function used to always be at my grandparents' house. They had about three movies. Most of them were Frank Sinatra and Elvis
Doubtfire.
Movies. But they had Mrs. Doubtfire, which is still a fucking hilarious
phenomenal
movie.
Flick.
It holds up really well, and it's about as old
as us. I think
that's
one of my brother's favorites.
It's still one of my favorites. And that one... But that one doesn't have the same sort of thing that I'm thinking of. I'm thinking more like...
There was a character
like, who was like anti-establishment, all this fucking stuff. Yeah. And then you watch him now, and he's just like... He's just a regular dickhead.
Yeah, I can't think of anything.
I can't think of anything off the top of my head, and I probably should have thought about this before I brought it up.
Like, again, like, going through, like, fuck, how many movies you watch
a
year?
Million. Maybe 2 million.
Like, again, like, to go back, like, I would have to... I will start rewatching some older movies that I liked.
Yeah, and as I think of them, I'm going to start writing them down so we can bring this back up later.
Yeah, send me
them,
and I'll watch
them, and
I'll tell you.
There is definitely a few...
If you guys have a film that you want us to watch and
send it to it's CJ Shade on Instagram.
Yeah. Let us know. We'll watch it. Except The Last Samurai. Rob.
Wasn't that bad.
He's so mad, man. He wants me to watch it so bad for the past like 5 years.
Have you not seen it yet?
Never watched it. I always told him I would and then always forgot.
It's not that bad. It's a good movie.
New James Bond coming out in November.
Is
no date. Just said November.
2021, 22?
2020, I think.
What?
Which is weird that they, I think. I,
oh,
I
sorry.
I might have missed the date.
Sorry.
It's like a No Time to Die.
You're right. Sorry. Yeah, that's been filmed for a while.
Yeah. But yeah, it said November, but no, like, it wasn't like November 15th.
That was one of the many ones that got canceled with COVID.
Mm-hmm.
There was a shitload of movies. I was like, I think Tenet was supposed to come out. James Bond. There was a couple other.
Tenet
like,
looked good. I just never.
I think it's still in theaters. I'd like to go see it, to be honest, because that's a Nolan film, and he's got some good sound and. Fucking watching that on the big screen probably worth it because I'd probably just stream it or download it and the sound might be not the top quality that you want to hear in a theater. I heard it was good anyway.
Yeah,
but that James Bond movie was one of those ones that got bounced for sure due to the old Marchy April because everything wants to roll out March April start of the summertime, right?
Yeah, or like this time of year because the awards are in what. January?
I'm not sure.
Or end of
something
November.
Something like that, yeah.
It's something like that for like the year or like, I think it's in January they do the awards for like last year. I have no fucking clue, but usually good movies come out like March, April, and then there's like the summer
and
break
the
where kind of cheesy movies come out. And then the fall, again, is
like your Fast and the Furious of the worlds come out in the summertime.
They come out in April.
Do they?
Yeah.
Fuck. There's me being a dickhead.
Yes, no. The last 17 have come out in April.
Last 17, he says with a straight face.
Yeah. Oh, Jackass 4 is in the works. They started filming it, and then it got shut down due to COVID. But, like, they were in production, like, before everything got shut down in March.
You know, I just saw a clip. It's funny you bring that up, because I saw a clip of, you know, when Johnny Knoxville dresses up as an old man? Of him coming out of the water with this big fish from a movie I haven't seen. He's like, I got one. And it's a big fucking fish. And then he falls over, and it's got a huge fucking dick, and it falls right onto his face. And he does this in front of people. So I guess that's probably from...
That's not old Jackass.
One. No. It's not Bad Grandpa. Was it in Bad Grandpa, the fish? I don't think so, dude.
It was either in Jackass 3D, because 3D, no, they had a lot of dildos. No,
it's
not in
that. I've seen that movie a bunch. It's not that. I'll show this to you after. I'm sure this might be a clip from 4. I didn't even know they were filming it.
He's done a lot where, like, he's pulled out the fish. Now the fish has, like, a giant dildo, like, where a dick would supposedly be on
a fish.
Okay,
so maybe I'm wrong then. Maybe it is from an older one.
Have you seen that? That one's been done.
Ah, fuck.
Well, but I was watching an interview.
I'm still living
with,
in 2008.
Steve-O, he was on The Fighter and the Kid, and he was saying how, like, they started filming Jackass 4 and got shut down because of COVID, but it is in the works. It's happening.
speaking of dumb movies, those movies suck me in
every time. I watch those
now, and I belly laugh like it's the first time I've ever seen it. There's something about watching people puke and hurt themselves that makes me get
it. There are some stunts, and it's like, okay, like, that's a...
Oh, super dangerous, most of them.
Not even dangerous. It's just, like, the dangerous ones are usually the funniest. But it's, like, there's, like, some that are, like, really, like, that's the best you guys could have thought of.
Yeah, and that's what made it to film. So, you know that there's a million that are fucking way worse
than
that.
So bad. Like, I love the ones where they would, like... fall through like a roof. Oh, like it was in like the original Jackass.
Into like, unsuspecting people, like it's a bank robbery. Diamonds go flying everywhere.
Oh man.
They did some fucking the one that to this day if I watch it fucks me up. I think it's one of the first scenes of Jackass 2. And they hang a fire hose from a crane and the guy jumps on it. It's probably like 6 feet off the ground.
Yeah.
And it's like fire hose roadie or something like that. He rides it like a bull. Oh my god.
Yeah, this is insane.
He gets whipped around 15, 20 feet at a time, and when he goes flying, he gets lost. He's crying when he gets up, and I know this is fucking bad, but I'm in tears watching. I can't breathe. I'm laughing too hard. I'm just so dumb.
Like
I just love it.
Especially that stunt felt so cartoonish. Like,
oh,
there's like
hilarious.
No way this is real, but it's fucking real.
It's
like,
too real.
That thing's fucking flipping you fucking around, man.
Oh my god.
Holy shit.
I like it.
Oh, man.
Here's a fucking creepy thought I had.
Okay. I got like another, not rant, but.
Go for it.
Yeah?
Yeah. Let me piss and then go on your rant.
Okay. Yeah. Go pee. We'll take a break. Go on your rant.
I've been hyperhydrating. I apologize.
What else is new? This man drank like 4 liters before showing up to the golf course. Then drank 2 bottles on the course. And after the second hole, pissed on every hole. Not literally on the hole, but...
I've been doing that since I was a kid.
Fuck.
I
don't know how you get down as much water as
I don't know how I haven't been checked for bladder cancer. I fucking pissed on every highway from here to PEI and back.
So I heard, could be false
when
news.
When I was like 5.
Could be false news.
Fake
But
news.
I heard... Sure. Super shit. If you drink too much water, you can like drown your brain.
Well, my brain was drowned many years ago.
Okay, so that explains
it. Doesn't it look like I have a... All right.
No, it looks like you got your head stuck in a fucking chair. For those of you that don't know, he did.
Well, I'm sure the first time you came to my house, you should set this up right. The first time you came to my house on my parents' fridge, you know how most people keep photos of like, drawings that their kids did or whatever. My parents had a photo of me with my head stuck in a fucking chair. That's the type of genius I am.
God, dude. Fucking awesome.
I'm going to look up this water brain thing.
Yeah, do it. So my thing here is, I don't know. I don't think you send too many emails. But my thing is, for emails, are you keeping them, like for you? Are they like formal, very formal and professional, or are they more casual? I think this is something more like.
No, I send emails for work.
Yeah.
I keep.
I think,
them,
but I think though, like, what's Antonia your definition? Would have a better.
What's, oh, she would know for better, sure. What's your definition of formal versus casual?
Like, like very professional, like fucking.
I go.
Everything
like,
is like super proper.
I'll start it with like hello, comma, indent, down to a new paragraph, hit it.
Yeah, but when you're fucking you. Typing it out, are you being like super?
I'm focused on my grammar.
Yeah. Okay. And spelling. Obviously, but like,
well, I don't know what you mean.
Or like the way you're saying things in the email, are you like casual about it, or is it like super? I don't know, like corporate almost.
Nothing I do is corp, but I do know what you're saying.
Does that explain it better?
I think
like,
so.
Like trying to like stay more, I guess corporate, like corporate professional.
I try to look professional, I guess, when I'm doing it.
Yeah.
Yeah, as best as I can. Like maybe too much detail, but it also depends on who the email is going to. But most of the time. It's into extreme detail, like this is what we did, this is how it's going,
right.
This is what we're going to be working on.
Yeah,
I would say if I'm sending emails, it's more formal and professional, yeah.
Than casual?
With my drowned brain.
Yeah. See, for me, like...
But if I was going like to send you an email, I'd be like, eat my asshole.
Well, no, I'm not saying like that. It's like I feel like when I, like... And it's just because I've been sending emails like crazy like this past month. But it's like... I feel like also in an email, like I want my personality to come across. Like I don't want to be like sound like I'm fucking head of HP or head of fucking something, and you're fucking like underneath me, and you know, like
I for want, you that makes perfect sense because
I, like
you,
I want to be casual,
your,
like
but I'm, you are your business.
I'm definitely like trying to keep it like more like proper and like professional. But also like...
Yeah, not too professional, not too formal.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Like, hey, I'm a real person.
Yeah. Yeah,
I just, but that makes sense for you.
Yeah, I just wish
your business
like,
is your name.
Yeah.
And when you're communicating with people, they're communicating directly with the owner. You're directly representing your... So, but when I send emails, I'm representing a company.
Yeah.
And multiple people. I'm representing... Like, also when I send an email... I'm not just representing the company I work for, the general contractor we're working for.
Yeah.
All the people
like
working for, like,
fucking
when I'm at the hospital, I'm working under five different fucking companies.
Yeah.
So if I sput off on an email looking like an idiot, it reflects.
It makes everybody look like
makes
an
everyone
idiot.
Look stupid.
Yeah.
Now,
no, I get
that. But that said, if I owned this company and wanted to sput off like an idiot, it's my company. I'm representing myself. That's on me at the
You're
end of the day.
Thing,
so for you, I guess that makes sense to.
Like, I'm not saying I'm going to fucking send an email and be like, eat shit, motherfucker.
I don't think you have to do it both like, ways, though. I think you can find a happy medium
yeah,
for sure.
And like, I've just been thinking about it recently. It's like, man, like, fuck. Like, it's just so annoying. Like, sometimes, like, I feel like in an email, it's got to be so fucking proper and fucking corporate almost.
But think of it from their perspective, though. The reason that it's probably corporate is because they're working for someone.
Oh, but usually... No,
it's companies
usually,
you're dealing with, though, no? Or even,
well,
if,
no,
it's a, even if it's a real estate agent, they're representing a broker.
No,
a
see, for me, like, I'm dealing with, like, custom home builders, so I'm usually dealing with the dude that owns the company. And, like, don't get me wrong, like, some of them are...
So people are so fucking scared of getting a screen scrap and getting thrown up on Twitter for being a dick.
It's just so annoying.
Everyone's
fucking
just being very
cancel culture funny. Is fucking stupid.
It's real and it's stupid at the same time.
Maybe, I don't know. Well, no, that's just a thought.
No, go on. I want you to elaborate on that because so you're dealing with
like if somebody
like a general contractor.
Let's say somebody is listening right now and they wanted to reach out to me. Like, you don't have to be like super fucking corporate. Now, that's not saying like don't send me the fucking details. But give me the details for the job. Like, I have people send me, they're like, yeah, can you shoot this? But it's like, for me, it's like, can you shoot this project? And it's usually a fucking house address. It's like, sure. But you want to tell me what the project was? Was it a full build? Was it a renovation? Was it an addition?
What
was it just
at?
A kitchen? Like, what's the scope of work here? Like, I got nothing other than, can you shoot this?
Yeah, the problem is most of the time they're just phishing emails to see if you're interested.
Yeah.
And details to follow is probably at the end of all those emails, for sure.
Oh my God. No, it's me. Like, I have some people reach out and it's like, okay, cool. Yes, I can definitely shoot your project, but I have a bunch more questions. It's like you send your first little batch of questions, you get answers back. A lot of the times they only answer like two or three out of six. And then it's like, okay, cool, fine. Here it is again, but here's two additional ones that I didn't ask in the first place because I knew you were only going to answer two or three out of the first batch.
Yeah.
And it's like, you just like, it's like, man, like,
it's
just
a game.
Yeah. It's like, and it's nice, like, once you, like, once I have clients and they come back, because, like, they'll be like, we need this site shot. This is what we're looking for. And this is what we want
to
focus on.
They know how to deal with you.
Yeah. But it's like getting there. It's like
getting to that point if it's a rapport.
Yeah.
It can be tough.
Because again, like a lot of the times too, it doesn't, it's not necessarily going to change. Like for me, like it doesn't have a very high impact on like pricing in a sense.
Mm-hmm.
Like if it's a kitchen, like I have a day rate and then you pay for your like set of images. So like if I shot 30 fucking images that day and you only want 10, well, I'm only going to charge you for the 10 because those are the 10 I'm going to edit.
Yeah.
You choose those 10, I edit for that. So you paid me for the day to shoot. Now you pay me for my editing time. And again, if we shot fucking 60 images and you only want 5, well, fine. You only have pay me for that editing time of the 5.
Yeah, no worries.
If I want to edit other ones on my own, I'm going to be on my website. But it's like, you just want to get especially and now with COVID, it's like I'm trying to plan out my day so that I can either move quicker in the house, like if it's interior stuff, so I'm not moseying about.
You want to be efficient. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't want to be in the house for longer than I need to.
Yeah, like, don't let me shoot this bathroom that you don't even want to fucking
use.
Yeah,
if there's a fucking little kid's bath, like a...
Yeah, whatever.
Or just like a half bathroom with the toilet and
unfinished
the sink.
Unfinished basement.
Do we really need a shot of that bathroom? Like, really? Like, is it anything spectacular? It's just a fucking toilet and a sink.
Yeah, call me up and just be like, hey, I need a toilet shot. And I'll come, just tell me which one it is.
Yeah, you know, like, so it's just like shit like that. And like, again, like, it, I think for some people, I'm like, hey, is somebody going to be there? Like, I'm not saying somebody needs to be there all day when I'm shooting, but is somebody going to be there at the start? And then we first 20 minutes is walking around being like, I really want to highlight this, or we're entering the photos in a contest.
Yeah.
And we have a before angle from here. So can you capture capture what you want, but we need a shot from this angle so that we can submit it to the contest. If I don't know that prior, I'm not capturing that for you. And then don't come back to me. Do you have that angle? No, you didn't tell me to get it.
I've just sent you all the photos I have.
Literally, like,
this is how it works. Yeah. You asked me to go send it and you like send me all images and then I sent you all images.
Yeah.
I wasn't like holding on that one angle.
I wasn't holding on anything.
Just like, oh, this one costs extra.
Yeah. No.
I knew you guys wanted this the whole time, so I just kept it in the back pocket.
Yeah.
Oh, you wanted that one? Sure, I'll go back and film it.
Yeah, I've had that too. Like, clients are like, oh, do you have it from this angle? It's like, no, did you tell me to get it from that angle? No, you told me you wanted the kitchen shot. I shot the kitchen. Usually a kitchen is a focal point, so there's like 6 images of the kitchen.
Yeah.
But if I don't get the like one image that they wanted, again, from a certain angle, because that's their before image, if you don't tell me that, I have no idea.
Hey.
I'm shooting in the fucking dark. And I'm not a mind reader.
Knowing this from before we moved up to here, we looked at a lot of fucking homes and saw a lot of homes that we never went and saw. Like, we were on a generating email where you'd see, you get 3-4 homes a day, anything that went up for sale within criteria. How do you guys make a fucking 4x4 room look like a...
ginormous fucking
look thing. Like a bedroom, because like they
it's
fucking
wide angle, so real estate, like I don't use real estate,
makes it look like when shit's shot in fisheye lens, that's an automatic tell, but I'm sure that shit's shot by like the homeowner or something like that.
So yeah, like
it feels cheesy when you see that.
Okay, again, it's like
oldest real estate, trick in the book.
Real estate photography is dog shit. I tried to get into it when I was coming out of school, because I'm like, oh, there's so many real estate. They don't want to pay for the images. And again, I don't blame them, because the listing only lasts like a week.
Yeah.
Especially now, or like before, it was like 2 days. They were doing pre-sales before it even went on the market.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it would be sold. So it's like, well, why do I need to pay for nice images? Nobody cared. But like, again, like a real estate photographer, all they're going to do is take their tripod, stick it in the corner of the room, use a wide angled lens.
And away you go.
And shoot a picture and then go to the next corner.
Oh, so it's really just that fun.
You literally just go
easy peasy
corner to corner and next thing you know, you're done. Don't get me wrong. Not every real estate photographer is doing that. But majority of shit you see, they're sticking their camera in a corner, wide angle, shot.
4 shots, done.
They're in and out in 20 minutes.
Yeah, fair enough.
There's no real thought behind it.
Yeah.
But yeah, the art form is gone. Really. That's how they make it look real big. And then trust me, it's not big.
It fucking works though.
Yeah.
It really does. We saw some fucking places out, like had us hook, line, and sinker on the photos and get in there. You're like, holy fuck. The floors are sticky. There's a fucking, yeah, like just like some, we've seen fucking ton of crazy shit, which is good because when you like, the more homes you go and look at, the more draining it feels. But it also was like, okay, this is why you don't fucking buy anything that you don't go see.
Yeah.
This is why you don't feel rushed to do anything, because something's going to fucking pop up eventually. Something and just fucking will let come it roll. Up
and it's just, it'll happen when it happens.
Yeah. It's fucking a wild game. Oh, I found the answer to your brain drowning. The answer is apparently.
Is it brain drowning or something?
Beware. Overhydration. Excess fluid accumulation can lead to dangerous low sodium levels or in the blood or result in brain swelling. Researchers sway, which 100%.
Maybe that's what it was.
Hyponatremia. That's exactly why my head's that big.
Has been swelled.
I can get $12 for this fucking pumpkin head at a farm. No problem. No questions asked. Right off the dock. Is a life-threatening condition of brain swelling is more common in elderly patients. Okay, so I'm not in a life-threatening condition, but can drink too much. If we drink too much, it can wreak havoc on our brain and body. Drinking more water than your kidneys can process can throw your blood sodium. So just sodium, just salt.
Yeah.
Which means I'm never going to have a heart attack.
I'm pretty sure there is like...
That's how it works.
Even though like, even if you were to get your sodium in too, like again, I think getting the amount of sodium in with the amount of liquid, like you're still taking in way too much sodium.
We're doctors, by the way.
It's like, yeah, I'm definitely a doctor.
No, keep going. But yeah, I don't know. Fuck.
I don't know. I heard it somewhere and I was like, oh, that's interesting.
Probably
Chris drinks a shitload of water. Don't get me wrong. I get my water in, but I'm not getting my water in like you. I've seen you crush like 4 bottles at once and then 3 hours later crush another 4. And it's like, man, that's like a person's daily intake.
It's weird.
What is it? 8? I think it's 8 cups of water is your... should be your daily intake. Now, give or take.
2 liters, yeah.
Like, give or take, like, if you don't get 8 cups in, it's fine. If you get 7, cool. Or if you get 12 in, like, again, like, when I work out, I probably drink 3 cups just working out, if not more.
So, it says how much water you should drink, according to the Mayo Clinic, which I think is a pretty good place.
Sure.
3.7 liters for men, 2.7 liters for women. Well, that's just sexist.
Yeah, that's definitely sexist. That's fucking bullshit. Shut down the site. Cancel.
Cancel the Mayo Clinic.
Cancel.
Fuck your cancel research.
Cancel.
So 3.7, I'm definitely getting that. I'm definitely getting that.
I would imagine.
But you know what's funny that reading that about the sodium thing is, you know when you just like feel like you were on the drink last night and you weren't?
Yeah.
And it's like, maybe that's, or like if you eat a lot of salty shit, your fucking mouth goes dry. I wonder if that's what it is. My sodium's a bit lower, but.
I have no idea.
I'm pissing constantly.
That's just because you
but I don't drink
excess liquid in your body.
I don't drink fucking tea, coffee, none of that shit. I just drink water.
Love me a good cup of coffee. And I like a green tea at night.
Yeah, that's reasonable, that's I'm sure. I can't. I literally can't.
I have juice.
I don't even like coffee in my car.
I know. I have juice every once in a while. Like I had orange juice the other morning for breakfast. Love me a glass of orange juice some morning.
Sugar though, man.
Oh my God. Only one.
Yeah, that's fair.
But like, again, like I don't drink pop. I try to stay away from all of that fucking shit. Like I'm drinking strictly water and a glass of whiskey on Mondays or Sundays. We got to start doing these on Sundays.
I know. Sorry.
Oh.
So listen to how old I'm getting. Hang on.
Let's sort this out. This coming week's Thanksgiving. When are we going to do the podcast? We're gonna do
Monday. Late? It has to be Monday.
You don't do anything Monday?
Monday we don't do anything.
You don't celebrate Monday?
Based on how our weekend's stacking
that's
up.
That's fine.
It has Sunday's your anniversary.
Audrey's is Saturday.
Saturday's
when's your anniversary?
Sunday.
Right? Sunday? Mm-hmm. Hell yeah.
11 on the 11th.
Anniversary.
Apparently you can have champagne anniversaries. Fucking Hallmark figures everything out, eh?
That's champagne a fucking birthdays. Hoax of a store.
Fucking right, man.
Jesus.
Yeah. Yeah. 11 on 11.
Congrats.
And Friday we're supposed to do some with my dad and then her parents Sunday and then my fucking again going back to whether Thanksgiving will or Halloween will happen, we're supposed to do my mom's side next weekend, but there's 19 of us, so
we'll see if that happens.
We're gonna try and do something outside with maybe like heaters and a tent so that we're legal.
Are your parents will it be at your parents?
It'll be at my aunt's place, which is just up the street. They have lots of space.
I was going to say, like, are they close to, like, neighbors or is there, like, some gappage?
They have a lot of trees and a little bit of space. That's all it comes down to, really. Like, if your neighbor's a dick. If
you were to do it here, I could see getting, like, you know, there's so many cars on the street. Everybody's piling into your house. You may get an asshole fucking neighbor that calls the cops on you. Next thing you know, you're getting tickets.
Anywhere else I lived, I would say yes. Up here, dude, the amount of cars on the street is outrageous. On Sunday, it was...
Jammed.
Everyone's on their lawn drinking and smoking. I wish I was making... I like it.
That's fucking
it's
awesome.
It's the strangest place I've ever lived, but it's really nice.
And finding Aurora is fucking bullshit now, man.
But I don't even think... It was never like that when I was growing up there. But I also
It's not bad because, like, again, like, our side of Aurora is all grown up now. It's all old people and, like... Dude, there's so much bullshit. Like, bro, just fuck off. I'm just trying to... Do my thing here. You go do your thing. Leave me alone. I'm not fucking hurting anybody.
Yeah, so I think we could have a rager in our backyard and nobody would say fuck off.
Fuck, you'd probably get people wanting to come over.
Yeah, we would. If we left the garage door open, that's an international invite up here. Yeah. But I mean, that's... And I think that's the problem is that everyone's scared is like, oh, fuck, what if the neighbor calls? So that's what kind of keeps you in line to, like, not have 26 people outside or some shit like that. We're going to try and figure it out. This is the annoying thing about them saying, like, you can't really have Thanksgiving is I haven't seen my fucking family since Christmas of last year.
Yeah.
Easter was fucking off.
Everything.
Any birthdays in between that we would have seen each other, all that shit's been fucking canceled.
Maybe you did a drive-by.
It's all been fucking canceled. So, again, now we're almost pushing a year.
Yeah, it's like, kid.
Like,
go fuck yourself.
Stop telling people not to see their families, man. I get, don't have a family fucking reunion where you're inviting people from out east and west and all over. But if you have a grandparent who has three kids, they can all invite their families, I think.
Yeah,
and that's all we're doing. We're not inviting cousin, extended family, none of that. It's just family.
If, like, somebody you just saw, like, maybe had a cough, maybe you don't go.
Yeah.
Or if you feel a little under the weather, don't go.
Yeah, let's all just be responsible.
Be fucking smart and responsible. That's all it is.
That's not a very hard thing to ask of people.
But again, it's pretty hard for a lot of people, let's be honest.
But again, I don't think we should hold ourselves to the dumb people in society. I think most people will be responsible and most people will go, hey, you know what? I'm feeling a bit under the weather.
Or you know what?
We're not going to attend.
I don't want to risk it. I'm staying home.
No problem.
By all means.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Stay the fuck home.
I don't like...
Do your thing.
I don't like people saying you can't see your family.
Yeah, no, it is.
After... Almost 8 months of fucking... Yeah,
being fucking
locked
isolated.
Inside. Because again, it's not just this holiday. You know, we can give without this holiday. It's you forget about all the shit in between. All the birthdays, all the fucking long weekends. Everything. All that shit's been gone.
Yeah.
So,
again, I didn't see you guys till fucking...
First 2 months?
August. It was like August before I saw you guys. No. Antonia's birthday.
That's June.
June. Yeah.
But the last this shit time started I saw you in March.
Was
March.
Rob's birthday, which was March, like, 15th.
Yeah. So that's because your wife works in a hospital. So
well, that too, but like again, like everything was shut down.
No one knew what the fuck to do. So just that alone.
Just that alone.
Now expand that to your family, my aunts and uncles that I'm very close with, cousins I'm very close with.
Fuck, I didn't see Audrey for a month and a half.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Until I moved into her place, I said, "Fuck this, nothing's getting better."
I don't even know how we got on that topic, but we're trying to do
welcome
fucking
to our brains.
Yeah, fuck.
Oh, I brought up the podcast when we were gonna do it.
Oh, yeah. So this weekend, Monday's probably
I'm
going
to pick up a new bottle. Maybe I'll crash on Monday.
Definitely crash on Monday.
Yeah.
I don't know.
We'll have a few.
I think we should get tuned up.
If you're around all day, maybe
all
I'll
day.
Come. Maybe
start
I'll come,
early.
Yeah, maybe I'll come a little earlier.
All day. And the only thing is I'll be hungover, which I'll be begging for a drink anyway. So it's perfect.
Yeah, if we don't get rowdy, we don't get rowdy, but I'll bring a new bottle. I got that bottle I want to bring. I didn't get it yet, but I want to get it.
Mm-hmm.
But I do want to pick it up.
LCBO was closed again today, wasn't it?
Yep. Actually, there was a fucking jackass guy.
I wanted you to try this anyway, so.
I wish I got his fucking license plate. This fucking asshole pulled into the LCBO, and I'm coming down, you know the lights there, at like Brooklyn and Yonge Street. Coming down, he's coming out of the parking lot, and nobody's there, but I'm almost at the light. So it's like, okay, well, I'm going to go because I have the right way. I'm going. Next thing I know, this guy's fucking pulling out, and it's like he has a goddamn 12-foot trailer on the back. He's in my fucking lane.
That's what trailers do, though.
No, he didn't have a fucking trailer on.
Oh, he didn't. He just was driving like an asshole.
Yeah, it's like, guy. Like, I have the right away. I thought you didn't
notice a 12-foot trail. I'm like, fuck, you know, what do you want from him?
Like, I have the fucking right away. Wait your fucking ass before you pull out.
Did you write his license plate number down?
No, I didn't.
So that's where you fucked up.
I was trying to pull ahead to give him the finger, but he was like so far, because he was turning right on the young and I was going left. He was so far out there. Like,
yeah. I'm pretty sure he was halfway sort of in a young street lane. But if you wrote his license plate down number, at least you could maybe remember bumping
I got a license plate though. There was a fucking lady, Go-Go One.
Don't say that. don't fucking dox people. Because all it takes is like $80 to look up a license plate.
I didn't tell you how to spell everything.
All right, fair. You know what I'm saying, though.
Yeah.
All right.
Relax. Could have been G0. Could have been G-O.
Anyways, how do you spell it? I'm going to write it.
Anyways, this fucking lady is coming to a stop at every green light.
Sometimes you have to. You got to be safe.
Fuck. I was getting so pissed. But it was like... I'm really a hostile driver.
You've been watching too many of the Fast and Furious movies.
I really noticed it at the booster juice right before Biscotti.
Biscotti.
And I'm like, oh my God, is this lady serious? And then she picked up. I'm like, I'm not even going to go around her because I fucking turned left here.
I got to turn anyway.
It's fucking ridiculous.
Joke's on you. You had 5 lights to turn around her and you never did leading up to that.
Two. Because she didn't get in front of me until like the Home Depot.
I forgot how small my town was.
Yeah, it's not very big.
It's too light.
And then there's actually, it's a little big if you go north a little. There's another big.
There's only 2 more lights, and then you're up. Then you're out.
Because there's another, like the LCBO Plaza is nice.
Yeah, that's one up from here.
Yeah.
And then there's one more after that, and then you're
gone.
You'll hit a set of lights like 2 kilometers, but it's always a through because it's country roads. Take me home, West Virginia.
Country roads. Take me home. All right, dude, there's a fucking ghost game. It's a ghost hunting game.
Oh my God.
Okay, and I don't do scary things.
Why is this podcast turning into ghost stories? I'm not mad at it.
Because it's almost Halloween.
Fair enough, festive.
Festive, we got a pumpkin.
That's is Antonia
making
pumpkin.
Us a pumpkin that says 2 seasons in a pod? I'm a genius.
She is now.
Put her to work.
She'd be happy to do that. She's a lovely woman.
She is. No, so me and Audrey found this the other day. Like, we watched like streamers and shit, and everybody's playing it because it's like almost Halloween. And literally, you're a team of 4 or like 1 to 4 being a ghost hunter, and you go in. You got a thermometer. You've got like a radio.
How do you get this?
It's on PC only right now. It's like,
oh, it's in a game.
Yeah, this is fucking ghost hunting. I thought we had
to like go to like an old abandoned factory or something. Cool, though.
No, this is just a video game. Video game. And literally you go in and like you have like a little radio thing you can take with you. There's all these things you can take. And like when you go in, everything's black because all the lights are out. And your flashlight, you can only see like this.
Where the flashlight would be.
Yeah, like literally can't see a fucking thing. And you hear like floors creaking. The ghosts will like... grunt in your ear.
Do you
sometimes.
Put a headset on when you do this?
Yeah, or you can have it through your speakers.
But a headset, like, it's
and you gotta have a microphone because one of the things is a spirit box.
Say, get out of here!
Which
go
is
on, like, ghost.
Yeah, you can talk to it.
Go on, get.
If you say its name, it gets pissed. Anyways, you have this like radio thing.
I hate when people call me Gary.
It just like it just agitates them. I guess.
How do you know their names?
It tells you in the like the objectives thing. It gives
We're going
you the
after
ghost,
ghost
name.
Gary.
Yeah. You got to figure out what type of ghost spirit it is. So there's like spirit, mare, demon, phantom.
Holy fuck, there's multiple genres of ghosts.
Oh my God, yeah. And you got to figure out, you got to find 3 evidence things. So again, you got to have the right tools to like determine it.
There's evidentiary.
There's an EMF reader that if like you're close to it, it'll start fucking beeping. And then there's this radio box, which they call a spirit box. And it's like goes through all the FM channels.
Just like a regular radio.
You talk into your microphone and you say, are you here? And it will go like nothing detected. I did it. We played the other night. Dude, I did it. And we played like for hours and I was fine. Like, I don't like scary things or whatever, but I was fine. And then I had to do this stupid fucking spirit box. And everybody's like, ah, they're not talking, nothing. Dude,
Do you play online with other people?
Yeah, like, oh, me and Audrey were playing, and then I've got a buddy, like,
so, like, when you go when you go through, like, this haunted factory, say,
yeah,
are there other people in the room with you, or, like,
you hear
other
people talking? Yeah, so you can be up to four people.
Okay.
So it could be all friends, or you can join, like, a random lobby and, like, play with randoms.
And go ghost hunting together.
And go ghost hunting. So I had this fucking radio box and I'm in this room. We found out this is like the most active room because it's cold.
Sexually
active. Freezing temperatures. It's a horror ghost. I'm in there. And so it likes the room to be pitch black. You can't have your flashlight on. No lights on.
It prefers when the lights are out.
And I'm fucking talking. I go, are you here? Nothing detected. I'm like, and there's a book that they can like write in. I'm like, can you write in this book? And all it goes is, yes. I'm like, I'm out, dude.
He wasn't jumped out of your skin.
I looked at the book. The book had writing in it. I'm like, I am out.
The book wrote yes, or it came through in the radio box? Came
through in the radio in my ear,
and then the book
had
writing in it.
And then it had writing in it. I'm like, I'm out. Like, you guys are going in there. Ah, dude, it gets the heart.
I'm sure it does. I did a VR one at Wonderland.
Oh, and it's in VR if you have it.
Yeah, I did one at Wonderland. I was on one of those treadmill things. And yeah. I was going through a haunted house. It's fucking freakier than it should be.
Yeah.
It's way too real.
Yeah, man.
There's a really good Black Mirror episode about a dude that goes, like, he does the VR gaming thing.
Yeah.
But it's, like, the realest version ever, and he goes through a haunted house. It's a freaky fucking episode.
I bet. That show is freaky as fuck.
Just generally, yeah.
They did a phenomenal job on it, like.
They've been nailing it. It
really makes you think about like technology and like way things are going. Like there was one episode about like online dating. And it was absolutely insane. And it's like, yeah, but that's kind of where it's going.
For sure it is. I'm sure we're already there. We just don't realize
Same, bro.
Yeah, that show is like just dystopian enough where it feels like maybe this is 3 years away or 7 years away.
Yeah, man. It's crazy.
You do a great
fucking Could also job. Be 10.
The only one that threw me through like a loop was like two. The very first, like, have you seen all the episodes?
No. Right. Only here and there.
Okay, go ahead. Watch you
spoil it.
No, I don't want to.
I don't care.
I want to talk about it next week.
Okay.
Watch the first episode.
Oh, I've seen the first one. Like the very first one? Didn't it come out like sporadically though? Yeah. Like it came out like the first episode that was released was like episode 5. Wasn't it like that?
Okay, so
I could be wrong.
When you click on it on Netflix, it probably takes you to the most recent episode. But that's like episode 5 out of 4 that they've made.
No, I know that.
Okay.
But I thought it came out like the way the episodes came out weird.
Maybe the very first episode they ever made.
Okay, I'll watch it.
Go on to Netflix. Make sure you go to season 1 and click on the first one.
Let me write this down.
Yeah, what?
Was Black Mirror?
Black Mirror.
Black Mirror, episode 1.
Very first one.
EP 1.
I'll look up the name
of
it.
I'm going to watch it tonight.
Watch it tonight. We'll talk about it next week.
Yeah.
Because it's one of these episodes. It's fucked. It's really good. Really disturbing. The most disturbing episode they have. Second most.
What's it about? Or do you not want
to? If I tell you, it'll spoil it.
Okay. Don't spoil it.
It takes place. This won't spoil it.
I think you're going to spoil it.
I'm not going to. I assure you.
Spoiler alert.
The queen's daughter, or the queen's granddaughter, the heiress to the throne in Britain, has been kidnapped.
Okay. Definitely haven't seen it.
If I say a single word more, it'll ruin the entire thing. So it's one of these episodes. No, I'm not even going
to say it the prequel to Taken?
No. Nope. Just watch it. We'll talk about it next week.
What's that guy's name?
Liam Neeson.
Yeah, is he in it?
No.
Oh. I saw the one with Miley Cyrus.
That one was fine.
Yeah, it was okay.
Yeah, that was season 4, I think. I've seen.
Yeah, again, I've watched them like here and there
sporadically.
Yeah,
everyone's fucking really good in their own creepy fucking shows, sick fuck way. But yeah, watch this first one and be like, I think you're gonna be like, this isn't gonna go. It's gonna go the way exactly how you hope it's not gonna go.
All right, so for the next like how many more weeks do we have till Halloween too, like. Maybe second week, like one more episode, and then it's Halloween.
Let's check a calendar.
No, we got 2 weeks. 2 weeks before, 3 weeks before Halloween. But so that means three episodes will air before Halloween. So I want you listeners to send us in your scary stories so that come our Halloween special. I don't know. Should we do the Halloween special before Halloween? Or I think it should fall before.
We could release it on Halloween.
Oh, we could do a like a just a special.
We could just, because Halloween's on a Saturday. We could just get drunk on a Saturday and do a Halloween special.
Yeah. Okay. So send us in scary stories. Give us your details. Your messages don't have to be very formal, but I want to know your scariest stories. Marina, I know you're listening. Your mom told me you have a fucked up story. So send me that. Again, anybody else?
Ghost stories. I was thinking about this after we spoke about in the first one. Again, I'm super skeptical, but I believe everyone. I don't know why. But I just don't know what the fuck it is.
I'm with you.
My aunt and uncle, their last place in Toronto, they had two homes ago. They fucking...
Uncle Scott?
Uncle Scott, yeah. So she was telling me that this place was fucking haunted.
Yeah.
They had a security system. I mean, these are things I ration on my mind. They had a security system, and every time at like 6:30 at night, the door chimes would go. And it was like front door, door chime. And then, like, is it like, you know, when you open a security system and go ding, ding?
Yeah.
They would go, you go upstairs, door's locked, no one's come through, no one's come home. Every day at 6:30, this would happen. I can...
Guys just come home from work, bro.
But it's not. It's just like, that's their story, right? So I can rationalize this out knowing what I know is like, okay, it's a malfunctioning system, dying batteries, whatever the fuck. She said that weird shit would happen is like you'd be in a room, the air and everything would be off, and fucking plants would start waving as if there's a breeze and shit like that.
Yeah.
The one she told me is every other night, the doorbell would go off. Ding dong. Open the door. No one's there. Every other night at the same time, like 7:30. Ding dong. Ding dong. It's a century home. And so like they thought it was weird, and there was other shit that I'd have to remember better, but there was a bunch of weird shit going on. So they pulled the fucking batteries out of the doorbell the next night. Ding dong. There's no batteries. This doorbell's not even connected. You can go to the front door, push it, it won't go off. And it goes off.
What the
fuck? Which that shit to me is like...
That's a little creepy.
That's a fucking weird one for sure.
I'm getting my ass out of that house pretty quick.
Yeah. My cousin, she was
up for sale the next day.
She was freaked out. She thinks she saw whatever ghost it was in question. Like, fuck but that. Again, like maybe if you're that on edge when shit like the doorbell keeps going off and door chip, like non, like innocent things, which can be easily explained to like dying batteries, a glitch in the system. Like this is just wiring. This is mechanical stuff. Shit breaks down. Glitches can happen. Weird shit can happen to anything, right?
Yeah.
But she swears she saw one. But maybe you're just so on fucking edge that you catch something out of the corner of your eye.
It's like we were saying the other week.
Yeah,
like,
man.
Literally, your mind plays tricks on you. Like, you just...
But I...
You
I
think you think see something and it's like...
When they're saying they're pulling batteries out of doorbells and you can't and even... And then you're pushing... And then you're like, okay, pull the batteries out, push it. Yeah, it's not going and it goes off the next night.
Yeah.
That's fucking strange. 100% of the time.
Yes. Yeah. I didn't even say more than that.
Fucking super bizarre.
Yeah. Not a fan of that. I'd be selling that house real quick. Yeah. Send us your fucking scary stories. We'll do a Halloween special. But yeah, I think that would be a good little segment.
I'm going to try and create, as we're talking right now, a email that people can send.
Why don't we just do it after?
Sure.
Like create a new email?
Yeah, good call. I don't need to do this while we're talking.
I can put it on Instagram.
Yeah, we'll have it. We'll definitely make sure we have this email on Twitter too.
Like,
yeah, we'll have this email ready before Halloween so we can do a Halloween special.
Yeah.
And I'll try and any story.
Come on, everybody's got a scary story.
Everyone does. I'm going to start writing. I'll make sure I take better notes and write them down so I can relay them accurately. But yeah, the doorbell going off, the door chimes.
Fuck that.
Fucking just weird shit, like stuff moving.
Yeah.
My aunt never felt creeped out. It was just like one of these. It's just a weird thing. My cousin was terrified.
Yeah.
But she was home more often than them at the time. I think she was just about to go to school. She was like 18. So she probably wasn't working, about to go to university or whatever. But
yeah.
Yeah, it was... When I heard that one, that was one I forgot about. What were you going to say? Marina had a scary story.
Yeah. So Aunt Lucy was messaging me and she's like, ask Marina about her story. So I figured I'd just wait and
get her to punch it up in an email. It'd be way better. Yeah.
So just
keep it very formal, to the point. We don't want to ramble
very
on.
Very corporate. Yeah.
Yeah.
Give us all the details, though.
Give us a fucking
break. We want the full story. But yeah, keep it very formal. Okay. Thanks. But the email, I will post about it as soon as it's made. If not, I can always add it in at the end. Like, I can just record something at the house.
Sure, yeah.
And just be like, oh, new email.
This actually ties in well because I wanted to mention this. I had this. These are fucking creepy thoughts I have while driving. Nice. Have you... I'm going to specify this. I used to be like a religious atheist. Like I was so atheist, I was almost like religious about it.
Yeah.
And now I'm so agnostic, I'm religious about it. I just think whatever the, believe whatever you want to believe. I think organized religion can be fucking weird, but believe whatever you want to believe. You have the freedom to do it and let me be free from it.
Yeah.
That's my stance on it now. But I don't, before I would be like, there's no God, there's no nothing, whatever.
Yeah.
Now I'm just like, I don't know.
Yeah.
So
I'm in the same boat. I don't know. I believe something's there.
Sure.
Or after, but like, I don't think, I'm more in tone to say there's multiple. Like, I think the whole Viking situation is more realistic with like Thor, fucking Floki, and like all these other fucking people than it is to say that there's like one almighty.
Yeah, like you're more inclined to like believe like a pagan thing, like the god of the ocean, the god of the thunder, like the god of the land.
Yeah, I think there's like more than just one fucking thing.
Yeah, so
I got the greatest conspiracy theory.
Hit it up. Let's look it up.
You want to fucking
write it down? Let's go.
Okay, keep talking. Tell me what. All right,
so I had this thought about how I don't think the devil's actually a bad guy.
Okay.
And the reason I think that, and I'm not a fucking religious scholar by any means, but my understanding, and I just kind of looked it up briefly, is the devil rebelled against God. He's a representation of evil. Bad. He's known as Satan, whatever all their fucking names for him, right? He's the ruler of hell. And when you do bad things, you go to hell and get punished for it. So
it's like your old movie.
What?
he was in the synopsis of the movie.
Yeah.
Online. He's made to be the bad guy, but then you rewatch it 10 years later and he's actually the good guy.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's gone totally flipped on me. Yeah. So if he's evil and the reason that you do evil things, and then so you're doing the devil's work, like if you fucking hurt a child or you kill someone, whatever,
sex
you
before marriage,
whatever, all of those things. All of those, eat shellfish.
Jesus fucking Christ. I don't know what the fuck I just saw. It was my hand shadow.
Oh, fuck. Ghosts.
But fuck me, man.
You're on edge now.
That tripped me the fuck out, whatever it was.
It was definitely a shadow off the screen of your phone.
No, it was like, it was my hand shadow.
Oh, fuck. I put LSD in your drink.
Fuck. That's what did it?
So the devil's evil. He corrupts your soul. God, to do bad things, and then when you do the bad things that he wanted you to do, you go to hell and he punishes you for it.
Yeah.
I got a theory that the devil's not actually bad and that he is just doing God's work by, he agreed to like run the underworld, you know what I mean? He's almost like the Hades of the fucking
deal. He's doing all the stuff that God doesn't want to, God can't take do, and he's
like,
for,
and, like, and they always say before like fucking Lucifer was God's favorite angel and all this stuff, and then he rebelled against God, and then he's been doomed to eternity and he's fucking evil. So why just logically speaking, I'm not going to go into the whole fuck, because I don't know the actual theological reasons for this, but just off the top of my head, logically speaking, if you commit a murder that God doesn't want you to do, and if you do that, you can't go into heaven, but if you do that murder, you can go into hell, where the devil wanted you to do it, and then you go to hell, and he punishes you for that. Is he that fucked up that he's like, he's that sadistic? He's like, I'm going to corrupt your soul. You're going to do exactly what I want you to do. And then when you get here, I'm going to punish you for it. It just doesn't fucking... You know what I mean? Have you ever thought about that before?
No, I always just thought like...
And I don't spend a lot of time thinking about religious stuff.
Yeah, no, I know. I always thought like if heaven and hell were a thing, like, and you got sent to hell, I just thought it...
Be a good party.
Well, you would just be down there, like, not with everybody that went to heaven. Like, I think it's just a different... And it's not going to be so, like, bright and glory. Like, you can't get a mojito down in hell. You can only drink fucking Fireball.
it's really on the nose like that. It's
like, you know, like,
yeah.
You know, like, you're not getting a little umbrella in your cocktail.
You get a little pitchfork.
Yeah.
It's one of those things.
Yeah, it's one of those things.
Instead of olives, we give you prunes in your martini.
Yeah. You know, like,
the reason hell is because it's really just, it's... full of puns. That's why. It's not, you're not punished. It's just
yeah,
puns.
Yeah.
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 Oh, fuck. That's, yeah, I don't know how, I don't even know why I thought that this was a good idea to talk about on this. It was just, I was literally thinking on the way home.
Like, I kind of like talking about it though.
I do too. I think it's interesting.
Like, I'm definitely not,
and I'm not doing
religious
this
type.
Neither am I. And I'm not either. I just thought, like, if this fucking guy wants to rebel against God so bad, anything that rebels against God in his mind is a good act. That's what he wants.
Yeah.
He doesn't want you to be good. So why are you
getting punished?
So why is he then fucking with you when you get down there? Unless he's like the most evil motherfucker. I don't think
he's like, ah, fuck you, motherfucker.
Yeah, he's like, joke's on you. He's like, I really like good things.
Yeah.
It's like, that's why I love to punish bad things.
This is just the extended room because there's so many people upstairs.
I think you just get down there and everything's fucking chill. Or he's punishing you and he's fucking torturing you for all of eternity because he's actually a good guy.
Maybe you just gotta live in a sauna for the rest of your life.
Just sweat it out, man. Yeah, you just gotta sweat this shit out.
Sweat it out.
Yeah, puns, like, hell is full of puns and inconveniences. But it's
like, when you're down there, like, what's the worst that's gonna happen? You're already dead.
Have you seen the show, So Your Pretty Face Is Going to Hell? Write this down. You should watch this show. It's on Adult Swim. It's fucking hilarious.
Your pretty
face. Basically, the premise of the show is hell is one big office. Like, they all wear, like shitty, like Dell, like... golf shirts and brown and like beige khakis and it says like hell on there. Yeah, it's like it's a bad office uniform. Oh, yeah. And all the people that work there are the demons who like went to hell and then they got promoted to being a demon, but they're also simultaneously being tortured by the devil.
That's hilarious.
So like the devil will come in and be like office meet. It's fuck. It's like the What's office, but in hell. It's on Adult Swim.
Okay.
It's fucking great. So the devil will come in and be like, hey guys, like hey CJ, I need you to take the fucking pedophile in room 3 today. You know, like shake things up, like maybe drown him a little bit, whatever. Like, you know, like it'll be like, it'll be like super casual. Like, no problem, boss. He's like, oh, by the way, while you're at it, I need you to eat this entire bag of charcoal. Like, just like, listen, these things are out of my hand.
Yeah, you just do it.
These are just a task. So like, they're also simultaneously being punished while they're punished. It's fucking, it's priceless. And it's their fucking uniforms that get me too. It's like, it's literally watching The Office in hell. Check that shit out.
That's fucking awesome.
Yeah.
All right. I think I'll save my conspiracy theory for next week.
Really?
Yeah, because I think this is going to get us going. I really think this is going to get us going.
Maybe you should save it.
Yeah, like I honestly think that... Like,
I just read what you wrote down.
If we dive into this, like I feel...
If we dive into this, you're not driving.
I'm not driving.
We're going to get drunk.
Yeah.
We'll save it for Monday.
Because I honestly think we...
I'm going to want to smoke a lot of weed before we do this.
We're already an hour and 40 minutes in.
Also, we don't have to put a time limit on these.
No. I know, but if this is going to last like at least another hour. Like this will be a full episode, I think.
100%.
But me and Audrey were talking. We're a little scared for you about your situation with your baby toe falling asleep.
Oh, really? What did Dr. Audrey have to say about this?
I'm like, has your baby toe ever fallen asleep after she watched the episode? She goes... No,
it has. You guys just haven't noticed. You guys aren't fucking tuned into your body.
The whole foot or leg falls asleep or nothing. Not just my little baby toe.
Listen, I don't know what to tell you. But you're fucking...
maybe his shoes are too
tight.
Maybe
you guys have been drinking too much water and you got drowned brains because you're obviously not in depth
with your body. Water.
Yeah, you're definitely not drinking enough water because then you can't feel your individual fucking toes falling asleep. I don't know what to tell you.
I just thought that was fucking hilarious, man. I almost forgot
that. That is 100% real. That was not... That's
no, I know
it Yeah. is. That is not any sort of fabrication. That is fucking...
Shit's so funny, man. I can't believe your baby toe falls asleep.
Fucking believe it. It's a real thing. And I do believe it.
It
happens to you, and just because you're too ignorant to believe in the baby toe doesn't mean the baby toe doesn't believe in you.
Oh, my God.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, did you have any...
I was concerned that she was going to be like, you for sure have diabetes.
No, she said you might have Parkinson's. I'm only kidding.
That one's a bummer. I'm not into Parkinson's.
Did you have anything else you wanted to go over this week?
I think I covered the devil. The devil,
that's all you have written down?
I didn't really have too many things written down. We did pretty well, killing it.
Everybody's like, what are you talking about this week? I'm like, whatever the fuck we want to talk about. Next week,
we actually do have something we want to talk
about. Yeah, it's going to be a conspiracy.
And I'm going to have a bunch of shit ready to go on that. And I'll be Googling the whole time so we can go through it.
Okay, well, I'll talk to you after where I'm trying to remember what episode it was, but I did listen, or you can watch it too, about somebody talking about the conspiracy theory.
Okay.
Or like how it came to me.
Okay.
All right.
That's fine. No problem.
Cool.
Do you want to do Did You Know, or do you want to just wrap it up?
Yeah, let's do.
All right.
Did you know?
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
Ba-na-na-na-na-na. All right. Did you know your stomach has to reproduce a new layer of mucus every 2 weeks?
No.
Neither did I.
Okay. Apparently, that's how Google bad. Did you know about your asshole?
Yeah, relax. Okay. Oh, I'm going to save that one.
A level of mucus.
Did you know babies are born without kneecaps?
No. What are our kneecaps, bone or cartilage? That freaks me the fuck out.
So it says babies are born with
no soles and kneecaps.
I don't know how to pronounce this fucking thing, but I think it's like cartilage in their knees that will eventually develop into kneecaps by the time they're four. It takes until they're four
to get a fucking kneecap.
Yeah, now mind you, give or take, some guys are.
So what I just Googled on Healthline,
yeah,
typically by age 10 or 12, the kneecap is fully developed into a bone. So you got 10 plus years
holy fuck,
of just no cap.
Yeah,
don't. A small portion is the original cap remains is cartilage, while the most portion is fatty tissue called the fat pad. Perfect.
A little fat pad.
That freaks me the fuck out for no reason at all.
Yeah. Did you know... The pig has the longest orgasm observed in mammals.
How long?
Lasting an average of 30 minutes, but can peak at 90 minutes.
90 minutes of coming?
Of an orgasm.
If I orgasm.
That sounds exhausting.
For 9 seconds, my head feels like it's going to explode.
Oh my God.
That's impressive. I think that.
Average of 30 minutes.
I think pandas take forever to fuck, though. I think they might have the shortest orgasm. They're like, they'll fuck for like 3 hours.
Hours and fucking 1 second. They're like,
have you felt anything yet? They're like, no.
No, it's not even in. It's just in between my thigh.
It's going to keep. It's my belly button, you idiot.
Oh, man.
90 minutes.
A peak of 90 minutes.
That's fucking disturbing.
That's probably like the longest like observed.
Yeah, what kind of sort of sick fuck is observing pigs fucking?
Sometimes scientists gotta be scientists, bro.
Yeah, also sometimes scientists are getting into that field because they're sick fucks.
Also, it could have just been somebody watching a pack of pandas or whatever you call them in the wild and then saw these two fuck and next thing you know, this guy's fucking.
I don't think that guy's all that good. I think that guy was super into pandas, like. I'm going to start hanging around with pandas
that
are leaving.
Is way more highly likely.
Pandas are. I know that pandas get out of school around this time. I'm going to start hanging around this pathway.
Oh, my God.
Think about it, man.
Yeah.
What's more likely?
Fucking creepy.
This guy just happened to get into science and start studying pandas fucking? Come on. I'm not buying it.
Did you find anything?
No, I was just looking at kneecaps. I thought you were doing another. Did you know?
I got two more here. These are my top two. We'll do this one. Bees have 5 eyes. Did you know that?
No.
So there's 3 small eyes on the bee's head to detect and help them escape from predators approaching from above. And then 2 visible eyes in the front that help them with navigation and recognizing shapes.
Sons of bitches.
I didn't know they had 5 fucking eyes, though.
No, neither did I.
Like, that's fucking insane. What? You don't need 5. Come on. Be realistic.
They obviously need 5. No. They can also...
That's why you can't fucking hit them on top of the head.
I got a fact for you. Did you know that bees see UV light?
No.
And that's how they help pollinate flowers.
Did not know that.
So they can track where another bee's been, and that's how they know that flowers need pollinating.
Did you know? I did not know that.
No, I think this would be interesting. Yeah, they'll so if like you were like flower hopping in front of me,
yeah.
I could see all the flowers that you landed in. Within
really?
X amount of time, and I'll know not to go there because another bee's
been there.
Because
you've already been there.
I'll hit up the other ones that you haven't done.
I'll hit the other ones. I got you,
that's how they fucking keep the world flowing.
That's fucking crazy. Also, save some of the dandelions. The bees are going extinct, and we need them.
We do. Yeah. And on that note.
I got one more.
Oh, you got one more?
Yeah, dude. Come on, bro. Why? You got one?
I got nothing.
You're trying to end this.
I'm not trying to end it.
No, okay. I got one more. This is my favorite because I'm I like bears.
You're a bear daddy?
I'm a bear daddy. Bears don't poop during hibernation. Now, this is my favorite thing of how they explained it. By eating grass and twigs, they create a plug or a stopper in their bowels.
Jam a cork up their asshole.
Yeah, they pretty much make a homemade butt plug for the winter season.
They're fucking dying for a shite come springtime. I've been holding this thing for 6 straight months.
Yeah, and that thing is ready to come out.
All right.
Biggest turtle head ever.
Again, hear me out on this.
Yeah.
This this scientist just stumbles upon, like, hey, I wonder how often bears shit.
Yeah.
No, that guy's fucking...
Do they shit?
That guy's at home beaten off to fucking animal bear shitting. Assholes. And he's like, he finally found a career where you can study how animals shit. And there's no way you could convince me otherwise.
I'm not trying to. I'm not trying
what do they eat? Twigs and berries?
Twigs and... Oh, shit.
Leaves or some shit?
Ah, fuck. I just deleted it.
It's fine.
Oh, bears by eating grass and twigs. So that'll bung you up pretty well.
That's way too much fiber.
Yeah.
Like you can drink too much water and your pinky toe goes numb, you can fucking eat too much fiber.
That'll definitely bung you up for sure.
Also, they're asleep.
Well, that too, but like if you didn't do that, you'd probably have, they'd probably wake up and fucking go for a shite.
I just think it's more
fascinating. Have you ever not
that they can just pack it in for 6 months.
You've had too much grease in your diet the last couple of days.
I've definitely woken up and needed to shit.
Woken up and it's like, God, I'm going to shit my brains out.
I've woken up, thought I shit.
Do you think that's how they wake up? Just it's probably not like
it just
as violent
in.
As ours. Like it's
sure
probably
it's
like a full log.
They haven't shit in 6 months. I'm sure it's extremely violent. I'm sure it's the most violent thing that's ever been.
I'm now curious how violent their shit is.
The most
first
violent.
Shit.
The most violent.
Have you ever? Okay, yeah.
It probably shoots like a
mind.
Fucking boulder out of a cannon, like boom. Like that thing's a plug. They made a plug, and now they got fucking 6 months of digestion, eating their own fucking body weight. Yeah,
oh my.
That thing's flying out of their
that
body.
That demonstration was top notch.
That's how it's happening.
Oh my god!
You don't. No one even needs to fucking Google this. I've already figured it out.
Oh
by the way, I'm that creepy scientist that's looking this shit up.
Have you ever had a shit where you take shit and it's like it's a good shit? Big old shit. And then like 20 minutes later, it's like, oh, round two. But it's like you just let go of the plug.
Yeah.
And now the floodgates are open.
Yeah. No, it makes sense.
So it could be their second shit that is the most violent.
You're thinking just like the most like watery, grossest.
Like fucking.
Like they needed to wipe six times.
Fucking Picasso the toilet bowl.
The old Jackson Pollock. That's a fair question. I still think that
like,
fucking...
I think that plug one...
That
like
plug one
most,
just hurts the most.
I was going to say, yeah. Like, when you have big-ass shit in it...
I've never shit out a twig.
I've never shit out
But I've sometimes shit out a peanut, and it catches you on the wrong spot.
I feel
spot.
Like
can
you
nick,
could digest...
Can nick
well,
some
maybe
blood
not
vessels.
Us, but because your stomach, you got to fucking produce new mucus every 2 weeks. That pretty... That stomach acid is something else.
That's also a human stomach. That's not even
that's
a bear
That's
what
I'm saying. That's not a bear.
Those motherfuckers
so like,
are probably every 3 days.
Yeah, man. They eat bones and shit too, right?
They definitely do.
So,
which owls don't, by the way, those pussies.
Dude.
Owls don't digest bone or fucking fur. It's like, no.
Get rid of this.
Give me your soft toy, soft tissue.
Dude, I saw it. So when I was up at my buddy's place there, we went out for a ride on a little extreme golf cart. I don't know, 4x4 thing.
One of those side-by-sides?
Yeah, the golf cart on fucking steroids.
Those things are crazy.
Yeah.
You can get killed on those easily.
Oh, 100%. Yeah. But you can get killed on a lot of things.
Let's
be
honest. That is true. That's true.
And we were going and there was fucking turkey vultures or some shit like that. Like a whole fucking whack of them. Dude, they picked this raccoon's leg clean.
Just bone.
Dude, literally, you could see every fucking bone. There was no meat left on.
Like, as if, like, you would, like, dry a skeleton, like, bleached skeleton, just nothing.
They had just eaten the meat and the fur. There was no fur.
Yeah, at least they eat fur.
Yeah, maybe.
If you're a vulture, you cannot be fucking picky.
No, I don't think so.
I get not eating bone, but if there's only fur on there, you're eating fur today, buddy.
They are fucking
put your bib on, you're eating fur.
Ginormous. Dude, I kid you not, the body of this thing.
Oh, they're big.
Was, like, 2.5 feet.
Yeah, they're freakish.
Maybe bigger.
It's comforting to know that they only eat dead shit. Because they could do some fucking damage. They could probably eat babies.
If they fucking learned that they could do some damage, we'd be in big fucking trouble. Like eagles.
Yeah.
They're bigger. Fuck those things. Wow, I love them. They're fucking crazy to look at.
They're cool to watch.
Yeah. Birds, though?
Birds freak me out, but weirdly, the bigger they get, the less they freak
me out.
Move
their eyeballs. They move their heads.
That's a problem. You should start.
I'm not a fan of that.
Move your eyeballs a little bit. Don't be scared. Look around.
Yeah, just move your eyeballs. When I said that, I
you
moved
went
my
cross-eyed.
Head. That too, and I moved my fucking head. Like, move your eyeballs as I move my fucking head around the room. Oh man.
All right.
Fuck, man, that's been a great episode.
That was fun.
I'm looking forward to next week, though.
I'm doing research.
I'm coming stacked on this fucking conspiracy.
Bring a bunch of research. I'm going to bring a bunch of weed.
All right.
We're going to dive right into it.
We're going to dive right in. I'll have a new bottle of whiskey. And that's it, folks. Your sponsor for this week is me, CJ Shade Photography. You need any photography, hit me up. The only thing I don't shoot is weddings. Hire a fucking wedding photographer.
But he will shoot your vagina.
I'll shoot anything other than a fucking wedding. Honestly, I specialize in architecture and product. So if you need any of those, hit me up. And on that note, we're out.
Deuces.
Deuces.